Motorcycle communication systems usually come in about two sizes, cheap and expensive. But I think I found a middle ground, a good one too. So let's take a look at the Vnet V6 Rider phone system. All right, so let's answer the real big question. Should you get this? Yeah, I think you should. If you're looking for something that's not cheap, if you're looking for something that's inexpensive, and something that's not expensive, and I would get it. If you found this on Amazon and you're on the fence and you're thinking that, oh, if I buy this, I'm gonna get a cheap quality product, I wouldn't worry about it. This does the job that it says it's gonna do for basically what I need, at least. I mean, it's been good to me. I've had this for a year and a half. We've pushed it as far as battery life is concerned. We've pushed it as far as range is concerned, and we've had it out in the elements, and it's, you know, it hasn't let me down. So if you're worried about this thing, if you've seen it online and you're like, well, maybe I'm not going to get it because it's really not that expensive, not super expensive, you know, I just get it. Because sometimes things don't need to be super expensive to be good. I don't know how to put that any other way. But if that's all you need out of this video, I mean, go for it. There's some links in the description that'll take you down to a two-pack version that you can purchase off Amazon. And the price is right. I mean, yeah. So for the rest of this video, I think I'm going to go into some detail, because when I think about communication systems, and I do work with communication systems quite a bit in my work 2.0, I think about three traits that I really look for. And number one is call quality. Number two is range when you have between two units. And number three is battery life. So we'll take a look at all of those things, and I'll provide a little bit of insight from what I've experienced having this for about a year and a half. And yeah, we'll also do a bit of a pros and cons, and I've got another single unit that I ordered here because I got a new helmet. I'm gonna put together another rig, which is gonna have like the camera and the comm system all going on. So I just bought another single unit just for that helmet. So I'll unbox this a bit so you get an idea of what you get when you get it in the mail. All right, let's set that up. All right, so let's take a look a bit at what you get when you pick one of these up. Now, again, this is a single unit system. Typically, you buy these as a dual unit. So you would get, you know, two of these. And you would also get basically double everything you get in this box. Now, this one is the one off my current rig. So we're just going to set that aside for a bit. So let's crack it open here. Get your instruction manual with someone's best effort to translate to various languages. And of course, you get the unit itself. So a little bit about this unit. This is a 6 rider capable unit. So the way this shakes out is you have yourself, plus you would have the ride captain, and then you would have 4 other riders. And the way this works is that you essentially just hit this button here, you have volume control here, and you'll hear like a really loud noise that'll just let you know that you've connected to the rider. And then you can select different riders by hitting these buttons. And that's really cool. And after that, you just basically hear each other talk. So what's a really good pro about this? Number one, I guess the pro would be that it's a 6 rider unit. I know there's a lot of units out there that only have capability to have 4 riders to them. So that's a big bonus when you can have more people. Now, I'll never probably ever have 6 riders hooked up to this. It's rare for me to go out with a comm system to have more than, you know, 2 actually. But it's there. So one of the big parts of this that you get is the earphones and the microphone here. It comes a little fuzzy already. So you have this cord that you have, and it's a 3-ring system, so it's not 2-ring. And the reason that for that is this is actually powered by a charge cable that looks quite similar. So you route the wire through your helmet. Here's the little pockets that you use on the side of your helmet to put these in. And you can even have, you know, this Velcro here attached to the inside of the helmet. Now that's what I did. I removed this little white stuff and then I put it inside mine. I will say this, a con for this is these are not comfortable. I've gotten used to mine, but if you all you have is this on the side of your helmet and there's no other fabric or any kind of padding and your ears are right up against this, well, it's going to hurt your ears. All right. So that's a drawback. I don't know if like more expensive comm systems have like lazy boy type technology for, you know, ear comfort, but that's what I get out of this. So what do you get in the bag? So So number one, charge cable. For me, this is another con, actually, unfortunately. This charge cable is really unique. It's a three-ring charge cable with a 3.5 millimeter jack. So it goes in here and you charge it to the USB. Now, I only have one of these in my entire repertoire of charge cables. So if I lose this cable, I have to somehow find something similar on Amazon or something. I haven't had to do that yet because I've been very careful with where I put this. So it would be nice to have a little bit more of a universal, you know, charging cable for this, you know, maybe something like USB-C on the port on the back, but you know, that's just the way they decided to go. It's not a game killer or anything like that. It's going to kill the vibe for me on this one. You just gotta, you know, if I was going to give you a recommendation, just keep track of this guy. So other things that you get, a couple extra Velcro pads for whatever reason. So I guess those are good to have. And then you get your mounting hardware, so you get some screws. So the way this works, essentially you have two screws holding the mounting clip onto a little bit of a bracket like this. And you have two options for this, I guess. This one here is a little bit more extended. So if you have a little bit more padding or if there's a little bit more space, you can use this metal bracket here too. For my next build, I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do with it yet, but I think I'm going to use this metal one because I will say that this plastic broke right here at the seam. And I had to fashion my own little one here. So let me show you how that kind of looks. So here's the helmet rig right here. So you can see we have this section that's that mounting unit right there. And you know, I just kind of pop it out. I just cut up some plastic and just put that on there. It's not a really great solution, but it actually holds on quite well. But the way you would put this together, if I was gonna put a new one on here, is you would take off the two screws, sort of assemble it onto your helmet. So once you've loosened it off, if you have enough space here, you just kind of slide it up in a similar fashion like that. And then you would tighten down the two screws. So if I just pull the padding back, you can see the two screws there. You just tighten those up and away you go. But again, like I mentioned, that plastic mount did fail on me. So again, it's another con. But it's a con I can fix. So another pro about this, it's actually quite rugged. You know, I've had this in the rain, the dust, there's been mud all over it. And I've had to clean it up a couple times, but it's always worked for me. You know, we've been putting through these things through their paces quite a bit this year, and it hasn't let me down. So that's kind of good. You can tell, even looking at the enclosure for this, that it's a very well-sealed piece of electronics. And even the port, actually, where the headphones and the microphone connect, it's actually welded up a little bit so that when you connect it, it's a really good, you know, ingress proof seal almost. So yeah, it's rugged. But let's talk about our first of our three attributes that we want to look at about this. Let's talk about call quality. Let me set it up here so that you can kind of hear what we're talking about. Hold on a second.
All right. So what you're hearing right now basically is the call quality. I've got it set up so that I have my the lapel mic that I normally use for like right here. When I do these, I have it set up right next to the speakers, the little headphone speakers for the communication system. So what you're hearing right now is basically the quality of the call that you would get. And you know what? I've never really had an issue with it. I've always been able to hear, you know, most things that are happening. And one of the things that I really like about this is that it seems to have some sort of way of identifying if there's actually voice coming through, and then it turns on. It begins to transmit. So a lot of the wind noise doesn't make it through when you're riding on the highway. For some reason, it's almost like a squelch where it has to overcome a sort of noise floor at a certain decibel rate in order for it to transmit. So I haven't really run into any issues where it hasn't transmitted before, but it's actually worked quite well. So I really enjoy this. Now, I'm not sure how the quality of this compares to something to like a Senna or a Cardo. I can only imagine that it must be, you know, much better. But if this is actually good enough for you, then, you know, by all means, this is a great system. So that's the first element of it. That's the first check in the box when I think about a communication system, whether or not it's good.
let's go ahead and see about the next one. Let's talk about range.
All right, so let's do a bit of a range test. So I'll show you what I got going on here. I just got this hard pack right here with the communication system inside of it. And I just got a digital audio recorder looking after that right there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to close this up, put the transceiver on top. And then that way I should be able to get a good recording of what we're going to be hearing on this unit. And then, of course, I'm wearing my helmet, which is kind of weird in the middle of a field like this. But, you know, we do what we do. And that way I can talk to it. And what we'll do is we'll move out down through the field and we'll check the distance from this location. I've got it dialed in on GPS every once in a while. And we'll check quality. We'll see how it works. All right, let's move out. Here's hoping we don't get too much interference from the cell phone use and the digital audio recorder, but we'll have to see. Let's do a range check in here real quick. Where are we at? So this is range 129 meters. So that's one thing I've noticed over the course of using this comm system, is that range does seem to cut out like fairly quickly, but I think that's to be expected based on the price that you're paying for. At that point there, you're just, you know, fighting against, you know, transmission power that you have within the unit itself. So we were getting a pretty inexpensive unit with a long battery life. It means we're not pushing out a lot of power. So that means our range is going to be limited. All right, let's do a range check here. So we are now range 250 meters. So one thing I mentioned is it feels like we've gotten a lot of range out of this, but I'm not sure how much range we've actually gotten out of, because a lot of the riding we do is pretty close together. You know, like trail riding, we're not too far apart from each other. Because when you're trail riding, you don't want to get too far away from your partner in case something goes wrong. So, it's hard to say how far he can get before this thing starts cutting out. All right, let's do a range check. So, range check, approximately 350 to 360 meters right now. I think this is fox or coyote. Almost looks like coyote. All right, I'm starting to hear the breaking up. So we're getting close to the range for this guy. All right, let's do a range check here. I'm starting to see hear a lot of interference. So we might be getting into the outer limit of this one. All right, range is approximately 420 meters. Give or take about 4 meters, plus or minus. Let's keep pushing it to the end of the tree line there, and then we'll do another range check, and we'll call it and head back. All right, that probably has got it to its outer limit if it's not gone already. I'll have to hear back the audio from the actual other receiving unit down there, and then we'll...
All right, that's enough of that. So the Vnet 6 Rider communication system claims that it can get up to 1,200 meters, but I really don't believe it. I mean, what we got here was about, you know, some fairly good comms at 500 meters, but really, I'm thinking about 400 to 450 is the sweet spot for this one. That's about as far as I would push it out. And for me, I've never run into an issue before with that because I really ride quite close to the other riders in the groups that I ride with. So we haven't really gotten that far away from each other for it to be an issue as far as range is concerned. And if it does, we usually just adjust ourselves and, you know, form a tighter packet of riders if that does become a situation. But I find this really excels for trail work.
Steep drop off bridge and rut on right side. Yeah, right side disaster.
All in all though, I think this is pretty decent. Let's take a look at another perspective to give you an idea of how much distance, you know, physically, we had at the various points that we were looking at. So right here, this is where we actually put the little black box, the receiving unit. And right here is where we had around 400 meters.
So the last big thing to consider
of the three things that I usually think about is battery life and how long can this last being on all the time. Now for us, we've had these on quite a long time. When we were doing our Cape Breton trip, we had them on pretty much all day. And then we would get into camp and we'd disconnect all of them, consolidate them, and then charge the batteries overnight. So I've never run into a situation where the batteries died on me with this one of these. From what I can tell, the best battery life scenario I've gotten out of this is probably 8 hours, which is, you know, quite a bit of time for something to be on all day long for 8 hours straight and to be packaged so small. I mean, that's really good. I know a lot of the larger or the more expensive options like the Cardos and the Senna, they tout that they have upwards to like 13 hours battery time, which is crazy. But it's really good to know that you can go on a longer trip like that. Because usually when these get brought into the game, you're on a longer trip. So it's good to know that you have a little bit more battery life there for you. And these are just, you know, awesome in general. You know, it's so great to be able to have a communication system, because when you're out riding with friends, it's always awesome to be able to chat and to talk. I know when me and Brandon get riding with these things, we're always talking all the time. And more on to a point of like trail riding a dual sport, we're always sending call outs to each other about the trail. So if someone's in the lead, they're calling out the mud, they're calling out the ruts, they're calling out the good lines to us. And also, it is the crux of our dual vlog system. If I didn't have a communication system like this, I wouldn't be able to capture both of us talking to each other in the camera changes of our dual vlog videos that we do. So it is a real big deal there. But overall, the biggest thing I like about this is the fact that it makes, you know, having a comm system accessible for people that don't or aren't able to really put that big investment in. So something that sits under the $200 mark is really good. I'm all about making it so people can enjoy their adventures while not having to put out a lot of money for it. Anyway, I hope this helps you if you're on the fence or if you're looking for something that's a little bit more inexpensive, a little bit more cost effective for a communication system, a rider communication system. This is one I'd recommend for you. If you want to go ahead and save up the dollars and get something a little bit more expensive and go after the Senna and the Cardo, you know, eventually I'll probably get there, but you know, I'd recommend going after that too. Anyway, until the next time we ride together, until the next adventure we go on, I will see you then. And if you're interested in, you know, catching us when we're out on our motorcycle adventures, I totally encourage you to subscribe to the channel because we do new videos every Monday. Those are motorcycle adventures. And I do little reviews and little things in the workshop like this too. Anyway, until then, take care.